Go and see if the old Ford starts here. This shit was snow, but now it's kind of igloo material. I don't know if this fucker's gonna run, but I need it to so I can back it up out of the mud slash ice hole that it's in, mostly ice. Why are those on? Okay. Oh yeah. Fired right up. Oil pressure coming up. Temperature gauge buried over cold. Voltage good. Exhaust leak still present. I'm gonna be fixing that today, I hope. Maybe not. Either way, I want to make sure this bitch still ran. And it was froze to the damn ground. Are you surprised? I'm not. If you live anywhere on the East Coast, you know exactly what this winter damn wonderland's done for us. Cool. Now I'm going to look at that header collector gasket and see if I can't replace it. Unfortunately, I don't have a tripod anymore because they all died. Because that's the way it goes. Yep. Yeah, these tires were legitimately frozen to the not mud. Yep. The only patch of ground that I'm going to see for a while. The reason I'm doing this is because the old, I got a new toy for Christmas. It's a, chemo something. I haven't even used it, but I'm getting ready to. Assuming it's charged. I didn't check to see if it's charged. Should be. I charged it. I think. Hang on, how does this work? Like that? No. I am having the difficulties. Oh, it's gotta go like that, doesn't it? Yeah, okay, so is it charged? Yep. So it's basically just a little cordless ratchet. I'll charge up those batteries fully once I get inside, but this is just solid ice. It's all just frozen here in southwestern Virginia. And this wasn't plowed, this was all hand shoveled. That's just, someone scraped the road a couple times, that's the only reason why it's as clear as it is. But we live off the main road, so nobody bothers taking care of it. Yes it is. Yes it is. I live in Virginia, damn it. Not Northern Virginia either, up near Maryland and all that shit. This is southwestern Virginia. Like an hour from Tennessee, and look at this shit. What the fuck is that? Piece of cardboard? Oh, I had to put tires on the Chevy, because those are from 2003, and they're kind of scary. Anyway, the exhaust collector that I got to get to is down there, so I think I'm going in from the other side where there ain't so much snow. I lied. There is snow over here. But not as much. Okay, so that one is good. That one over there is visibly darkened. So, it's warm. Sorry. Fogged up the camera a little there. So I think, yeah, that one doesn't sound like it's leaking, but that one over there does. I really don't want to fuck with that. I might just see if it'll pass inspection with a little leak. Or maybe try to tighten those bolts. They look a little loose, don't they? Over there. Yeah, it looks like there's more of a gap on that one than this one. This is why I hate headers, but it had them, so I didn't want to go putting manifolds back on, so that's why it's got the exhaust it does now. Sounds good. It's been on there for a few years now. Really haven't done many updates on this truck, and I'm sorry for that, because this is a really cool truck. It's getting some work done soon, though, in the spring, when, you know, I'm not living in Planet Canada. I don't think I can get under there to that, because the driveway is kind of humped, and I am kind of fat. I'm just thinking of reasons why I'm not going to do this. Yeah. Fuck it.
Now, the thing about Virginia inspection is that your driver's side door has to open and close, so you'd think that wouldn't pass, but as long as you can shut it and it stays latched, a good inspector won't really bother you. Anyway, back what I was saying about this wonderful rickshaw that I got here for a daily driver. It's acting up. Ooh, that came with sockets. I didn't realize it came with sockets. I guess I never did open it. Sorry. Squirrel! It's acting up. Sometimes it'll die at idle. And yeah, there's some new dents since I got it. Mud and road salt and shit all over it. It's got four different brand tires on it now because reasons. Some more dings and dents than when I got it because a jaywalking trash can came out and attacked me. Someone, I don't know who, but someone smacked the shit out of my bumper in a parking lot. Would you believe it was Walmart? It's drooping down there now. I've covered it in stickers. And, yeah, it's just covered in road salt and dirt and schmoo. And it's sometimes dying at idle. It has an evap code, and down fucking ice. Down here is a canister that you can't see. And I'm not crawling back down the ground. And it's supposed to suck vapors back up into the vacuum system to the front of the car somehow. I believe what is happening is it's actually sucking fuel up into the engine. But just like I don't feel like crawling out there and taking three bolts out to replace a small exhaust leak, I also don't feel like crawling out and taking off a canister that's potentially full of gas. Also, if I can dig it out, I'll show you why this truck is out of inspection and why it was parked. Wow. Okay. Cool. That's not it. That's it. Because I ignored a U-joint making a noise, and this was the consequence. Snow. Yeah, snow was the consequence. Anyway, it busted that, yeah, it's one of the old U-joint caps. It busted that open. It ripped right out of there. I had to get another one of these off a different drive shaft. Now, for a little while there, I was thinking about selling it, but then the car started acting up, so now I'm not. Anyway, I guess I'll just call my favorite inspector and see if he's got a opening today. I mean, he could fail it for the exhaust leak, but I don't think he will. It's not that bad. Everything else should pass. Rotors are okay. They're a little chewy, but they're not bad enough to fail. They got a little groove in them, but he won't fail him for that. He don't like these headlights. I've been promising him for a couple years I'd get rid of these, and I ain't. And they're DOT, though. They have all the DOT markings, and they're actually name brand-ish. What are those? Junwan. I take that back. They're a Chinese name brand. Little damage to the bumper. Here, the plate and the bumper's a little more kittywampus than it was because I fell asleep at the wheel one day, working 12-hour shift every 12-hour shift, and put it in a ditch. And, yeah, that's a chicken. Don't ask. Let's see. Did I do anything under the hood? Well, I haven't really done an update on this truck at all in years, have I? So I guess I'll just go over it. The Chevy needs a heater core right now. And the gas tank is still sitting in my kitchen, new and uninstalled. My cousin put a battery in it when he had it. Robbie. I helped him put an alternator on it some years ago when he had it. Which was fun because we had to change over to the pulley for the that was already on there. I'm not sure why, but I know the pulley that came in the alternator was wrong. Looks a little moist down around that radiator hose. But this thing's always lost coolant, so as long as it doesn't lose it grievously, I'm not in too much of a worry about it. The coil pack has been replaced. It turns out the plug was bad. We don't think the coil pack was actually the culprit, but, you know, it happens. Ah! Itsy bitsy spider. froze its little ass off. Yep. Go back to your home. How are you still alive? Hello? I can't get it to focus. There it goes. How about some arachnophobia for y'all? Hi there. You're too cold to be scared, aren't you? You probably don't want to live in there soon. Yeah, anyway. Let's see. Does it have... Whoa, the radiator cap's loose. Why is that loose? There's something down in there and it's green. Yep, so... Why is that loose, though? What the French? Okay, so the little ledge where it's supposed to sit on the end of the radiator is gone. It just kind of... There. That's going to be a problem. That's not the cap. That's the fucking radiator itself. Okay, itsy bitsy spider. You should probably run away now. Where's a good home for you? So you'll leave me alone. How about over here with all my other shit? Here. Go away. There. Now there's going to be 1,000 of them in that box and I've got to throw it away and it's going to be cue the violin music. And no, I won't really kill spiders, especially not outdoors, unless they're the murdery kind. Back to what I was doing. Brake fluid's full. Oil shouldn't look that bad after less than 2,000 miles, but it does. And I'm running good shit. Wix filter and all that. Valve cover gasket is definitely puking again on this side, and it's not getting replaced anytime soon because you have to take that upper half of the plenum off, intake plenum thing. This one's still, nope, it started leaking. Okay, so those lasted about 4 years and then went. Don't know the condition of the air filter. It ain't been changed since 2018. About 20,000 miles, so it probably needs it, but it's held together with zip ties and screws and bolts, so not fucking with that. I reckon it should be good to go. That looks like water, but we're going to pretend there's no water in the system, even though there's probably something frozen there, but I got to replace the radiator anyway, so. And yeah, this thing does have underdrive pulleys and headers and breather instead of an oil cap, but it's not really nothing to write home about. Oh, and if you're wondering, people not watching this video, aka Dodge people, will know that's a Dodge battery hold down. Yeah, okay, I just had to let you realize that. Dodge battery hold down in a Ford. Because it's what I had laying around. Oh, and for those of you that remember this truck originally, the billet grill's long gone. Well, my cousin put it back in, and I had one of these grills in. Then I had to find another one of these grills, which is in not quite as good shape, but I like it because it matches the patina of the truck. And I've got a set of, they call that Ardent, or Argent, black. And I've got a set of headlight trim to match that. And I'm going to get some factory headlights to get rid of those. Anything else? Rear gas tank, still no bueno. I mean, it works, but it leaks. Chevy, four new 265, 75? Yeah, 16s. White letters out, because that is how I roll them. By new, I mean brand used tires. Everything else, as it was, as it is. Still needs gas tank and other shit. Oh no. The vent's left open. And you know, anywhere the water can get, it will get. So, yep. That's the update right now. Can't drive the Chevy because it, I don't know how much gas is in it. It leaks whatever's in it. and the heat, of course, pissing out. It had heat, great heat for just a few days. Can't really trust the Nissan right now because it's randomly dying for no fucking reason. It always starts back up so far, but you know, how long is that going to last? So the third, it needs to be put back in service and get inspected. I can just drive it, but if I get a ticket, it's like a $500 ticket for an inspection out. And I doubt they just give me a warning, because, yeah, they never do. Gotta hope the shit thaws soon. You can see where it's warmed up some, and like the middle will warm up, and then it'll thaw a little, then not, then thaw a little, not. And I ain't trying to clean that shit out of there. It ain't gonna hurt none. Anyway, that's it for now. A little bit of a half-assed fleet update. Thanks for watching. Is it really a fleet if you've only got three cars? I'm going to call it a fleet because I really don't have room to put anything else. One-handed granny gear, what can go wrong? Really close to a tree back there. There we go. Okay, just let her crawl. Granny low. Not touching the gas or anything. Reason why this truck's getting put in the driveway and the Ford's getting taken out. Okay. And, shit, I stalled it. Can I back out of here if I need to? My clutch dump it. Yep, I can. Okay, yep. So it'll get back out of here if I have to. Do that. Good. Okay, so that was a cold start on this old bitch. She ain't been moved in weeks and weeks. And she just fired right up. Old shitty carburetor with no choke. It's about 35 degrees out here today, so it ain't that cold. Fahrenheit. Fucking fucked up windows and everything else. Good old truck. Yeah, you kind of got a clutch jumper to get off this shit. These tires ain't the best. But they're not from 2003, so they'll get by for now, but by this time next year, it'll have four brand new ones on it. A damn old open differential. Alrighty, now I get to put my Nissan back in the driveway and get the Ford out of the way. Yay. I'm gonna try to get inspected today.